I'm Kate Holohan, USA Today best-selling suspense author. My latest book is One Little Secret, but I'm not here today to just tell you about my books. I want to talk about a virtual event coming soon to a streaming platform near you, Noir at the Bar. Now, usually, these are held at actual bookstores or bars, but since we're all quarantined, we're going live online. The first group of fabulous writers, including me, went Friday, May 8th at 7 p.m. And we have another great group for you on Friday, May 15th at 7 p.m. In my last video, I talked about Katrina McPherson, Allison Galen, and Hallie Sutton. Today, I want to tell you about three more wonderful authors in the lineup, Mia P. Manansala, Steph Post, and Andrea Bartz. So let's start with Mia P. Manansala. On her website, Mia says she uses humor and murder to explore aspects of the Filipino diaspora, queerness, and her love for pop culture.
Her debut novel, Arsenic and Adobo,
is a culinary cozy mystery in which a young woman returns to her small Midwestern town to escape a failed relationship, only having to deal with her family's declining restaurant, matchmaking aunties, and her high school ex who dies in her family's restaurant. The book comes out in 2021 from Berkeley Random House, and I think it sounds pretty delicious. Next on our list is Steph Post. Steph is a wonderful writer of 5 novels and many short stories. Her recent short story, The Pallid Mask, was nominated for the prestigious Pushcart Prize. Her latest book, Holding Smoke, is the 3rd in her acclaimed Southern Gothic noir series starring protagonist Judah Cannon. Judah is the middle son of the notorious Cannon clan, led by an uncompromising patriarch who involves his son in the family business, crime. Her latest has Judah in a showdown with Tula Atwell, a Pentecostal preacher responsible for his father's death and Judah's own return to a life of crime. A power struggle within the Cannon family erupts, placing Judah in debt to Suki Lewis, a crime matriarch from across the creek, just as an irresistible scheme to steal a thoroughbred stud stallion falls into the Cannon's lap. Trying to solve all their problems with a single heist, Judah agrees to trust Dinah, an enigmatic drifter, even as his girlfriend Raimi's faith in him begins to waver. Meanwhile, Sister Tula is up to her old tricks, intimidating everyone in her path. Will Judah and Raimi survive Sister Tula and the darkness within their own hearts? Or are such dreams impossible in Bradford County? Nothing more than Holding Smoke. In a starred review, Publishers Weekly said this book was terrific and called Post a born storyteller who expertly weaves 3 disparate plot strands into a wholly satisfying, if inevitable, ending. Also reading May 15th, we have the wonderful novelist Andrea Bartz, whose book, The Herd, was named one of the most anticipated thrillers by pretty much everyone. We're talking Mary Claire, Newsweek, The Boston Globe, Book Riot, Pop Sugar, Crime Reads, Bustle, just about everybody. It tells the story of an exclusive New York women's workspace, which is rocked by the mysterious disappearance of its enigmatic founder, leaving 2 sisters to uncover the haunting truth. The characters are Katie Bradley, who's just returned from the Midwest after a stint of book research blew up in her face. She gets into the Herd community, which prides itself on mentorship and empowerment of women. And she gets in thanks to her sister, Hannah, who is best friends with the Herd's founder, Eleanor Walsh. Now, Eleanor has a tribe around her, and Katie Bradley thinks she'd be the perfect subject for a new book, especially given that she is about to announce something really big and really secret. The night of the news conference, however, Eleanor vanishes. The police suspect murder, and everyone is a suspect. Eleanor's husband, the Herd members, men's rights groups, and Eleanor's closest friends. Hannah and Katie struggle to figure out what happened to Eleanor, and in the process, must face the secrets they have been keeping from each other. Together, they must confront just how dangerous it can be when women's perfect veneers start to crack, crumble, and then fall away altogether. Now, Mary Claire called The Herd a propulsive thriller. Through every twist, these enterprising ladies will have you breathlessly trying to keep up with them. So high praise there. Go check out these books. They're available at Q and Willow, the bookstore supporting this event. And please support local bookstores. They are such important parts of the community, and they ensure that we're surrounded by art and literature and learning, and they need our help right now. So please go out, support your local bookstores, online sites. Don't go out, stay in, but support their online sites and get these books. And I hope you will check out the fabulous author's reading on May 15th. Until then, stay safe, stay well, and stay inside, hopefully with a good book.